All right, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make some tweaks to the Brave browser for some extra privacy and security and just make it run overall smooth and slick. This is still my daily driver browser for most things. I'm using it probably like 70% of the time out of the different browsers that I'm running just because it works really well. So I'm just going to show you how to make a few tweaks that'll make it just that much better. Now, the first thing I'll address before I get into the tweaks, I saw this come up not too long ago. Some people were talking about how Brave has created a couple of services now when you install it and then go into the task manager and look at the services that are running. There's a couple of services. One is the Brave VPN service, then one is the Brave WireGuard VPN service. I didn't see those show up on this install, and I'm thinking the reason for that might have been because I use Chris Titus text tool. That's the only thing I did different. But I will say I've checked this on other computers, and when the services are installed on there, that it always shows the services as stopped, so they're not actually running. Like even when you're opening up the browser and using it, they're not running unless you're, for some reason, maybe you like using the Brave VPN service. I think it's extra bloat. I don't care for it, but the option is there for people that want it. I'm just going to show you how to toggle all that garbage off if you want. But I just wanted to address that before we move on, that I have seen those threads come up on Reddit. I've seen other people mention it. I've checked, and on at least on the computers that I'm running, I have not seen the VPNs. Unless you're actually using it, then the services don't actually run, so it's not actually bloating up the background of your computer. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and move my camera here real quick for a moment, and we're just going to go through and start making some tweaks. So I don't know how other people feel about it. I don't like the VPN service. I don't like all this extra bloat, all this garbage, the Brave talk, Brave awards. I realize that it's a business. They've got to try and make money somehow. I'm not going to hold it against them, but it's not something that I care to run. So here's what you can do. So we'll just go ahead and get rid of this garbage real quick before we jump into the settings. And then also, if you right click on the VPN up here, you can click hide VPN tool button in the toolbar. So let's go ahead and jump in the settings, because this is going to be where we need to make the tweaks for the browser. Okay, so let's go ahead and start jumping through here. So the first thing, if you click over here on shields, we'll just work our way down here. So the trackers and ads blocking, standard works fine. The thing is, so when you are upgrading stuff to like the aggressive, it'd be similar to like on Firefox or LibreWolf, for example, how LibreWolf sets things to strict as opposed to Firefox's standard settings, which things usually will work fine. Typically, you can do aggressive here and get away with it. Every now and then, you will come across sites that get broken, but I've noticed like the ads blocking, even if you leave it on standard, ad blocking works really well. I haven't had issues with ads, including ads on YouTube, because I know the YouTube ads have been an issue. I noticed a few weeks ago where ads, like they would try to play, but they couldn't actually play. It was just showing a blank screen and then the video would actually end up loading. And then I think what's happening is updates are being made to the ad blocker. So like I said, I haven't had ads be an issue watching YouTube when using the Brave browser. So I've just been using the standard setting and it works fine. I haven't noticed ads on any other websites either. So that seems to work out pretty well. The upgrade connections to HTTPS, I've talked about this a bunch of times for good reason. I think that strict is a really good setting to have here, especially because there's so many security issues that can come up if you don't force HTTPS. It's just a good idea in general to make sure that's forced. That way you don't end up accidentally trying to go to a website and the connection somehow isn't secure. The browser should notify you when that happens, but if it doesn't, you wouldn't want to put in your banking details or details for merchant login and then have a man-in-the-middle attack happen. So it's good to just have that on strict. That way it forces it. Block scripts. This is something you can enable if you want to. This will end up breaking a lot of websites though, but it is an option. That's completely up to you whether or not you want to enable that. The block fingerprinting, this is kind of the same thing. It's very similar to LibreWolf and the Mulvad browser, because those settings, if you were to take those and look at how they have their fingerprinting block set up, theirs would basically be the standard of like this, where it's strict, may break sites. Every once in a while you may come across it where I've noticed this become an issue, especially with those browsers because of how they handle it, is the captchas. So you'll go to the captcha, you'll put in, it'll ask you for the word or whatever it is that it shows you. You type it in and then it just ends up in this endless loop where you keep putting it in because it gets broken. So if you block fingerprinting, so if you set this to strict, it may be an issue with captures, but I haven't really noticed any other issues with it, although by default, like with the standard settings, It does do pretty well with the fingerprinting stuff. It handles fingerprinting stuff a lot better than Firefox, at least out of the box. The next thing is block cookies. If you do decide to block all, this can end up causing loading issues with websites, stuff not loading properly. Overall though, it's not a huge deal. This next one, forget me when I close this site. So clears cookies and other site data when you close the site. This can save you a little bit of hassle instead of having to do like the control shift delete on your keyboard to clear out your browsing history. If you're using standard, if you come up here and set this to private window, you can actually set a shortcut on your desktop where it will launch in a private window every single time. That way you're not having to go in and clear everything. Everything just clears out as soon as you close the window. So you could set that through the desktop or through the shortcut. And in case anyone's wondering what that looks like, so if you take a shortcut for Brave, you do the right click on it and send to desktop as a shortcut. And then you go to the shortcut settings here, you right click, select properties. If you add dash incognito to the end of it, save that on your shortcut, your desktop shortcut, and then pin it down into your taskbar, then every single time you launch out Brave, it will open it as a private window. That way you don't have to goof around with clearing anything out. As soon as you close the browser, everything clears out. For some people, they might not want that. They might want to have stuff saved, so every time they load up their browser that it doesn't do that. It's entirely up to you. So this setting may work for some people. Other people might not want to have to deal with that. They might want to have stuff that actually works. Next thing we'll do is we'll just take a quick look inside of the content filtering section. So if you click on this, just something I'll point out in here. So you can come in and select other lists of stuff that you want to block. So you can do like you blocks annoyances, use with fanboys annoyances. There's a whole bunch of stuff in here you can select from the built-in pop-up blocker. One thing I'll mention, so the easy list cookie, this is supposed to block those annoying ass cookie notices. Every time you go to a site, they say, oh, do you accept all cookies or do you reject all? Or sometimes what they do, which you're not even supposed to do it, is hide the consent option to where you can't even click and say, oh, I don't want to accept cookies. I've noticed sometimes the cookie blocker works and sometimes it doesn't. So that's just something to be aware of. So this thing here, show the number of blocked items on the shields icon. You can leave that on if you want. It doesn't really change anything. The auto redirect AMP links. The AMP are these annoying tracking links that can track a lot of your web history. So you can click on this to learn more if you want. By default, this is turned on to where it will auto redirect things like tracking URLs in the AMP pages. This is what I recommend you have on. And then this says prevent sites from fingerprinting me based on my language preferences. I also recommend you keep this on. It doesn't break any websites. It works just fine. And then down here, it says allow Facebook logins and embedded posts and then allow Twitter embedded tweets. You can turn that stuff off if you want to. Again, I haven't noticed it break any websites. Things seem to work just fine. No issues with it. Okay, let's click over to privacy and security. So the first thing here is the WebRTC IP handling policy. WebRTC, for those that are unaware of it, it's a communications protocol and it's built for things like if you're going to use your browser for using things like Zoom or Jitsi, or I think Microsoft Teams or whatever, there's all these different communication things that you can use through your browser. So when it's set to default, if you're doing anything really sensitive, you should probably be using hardened Firefox anyway. The issue is if you leave it set to default, this allows WebRTC to be able to basically have access to your IP. And what it can do is it can leak out. So it says here, unless you're in a Tor tab, WebRTC has the right to enumerate all interfaces and bind them to discover public interfaces. Basically what this can do is this can leak out your real IP address. So let's say you're using a VPN, you're doing whatever, you don't want your privacy to be violated in any way where someone can get your real IP. What you need to do is select disable non-proxied UDP. But just know that if you do use like video conferencing services through your browser as opposed to using like a desktop app, could potentially interfere with it. I've noticed that before, like where you go to use a service and then it doesn't work because this setting here was changed. Next, this one is allow privacy preserving product analytics. This is anonymized info that helps Brave estimate overall usage of certain features. It's turned on by default. And then this other one, automatic send daily, automatic usage ping to Brave. I think it's a good idea to just go ahead and turn both of those off. It's not going to make the the service worse if however many people watch this video if you turn it off. It's not going to make things any worse than it is right now. Now, the clear browsing data, you can access this if you press Control Shift Delete on your keyboard. It will bring this up. So if you're just browsing around on a website and you press a Control Shift Delete, you'll bring this up, so you don't have to go into the settings and then pull this up this way every single time. This one, if you go over here to cookies, block third-party cookies is fine. You can leave it set at that. If you click block all cookies, which it says not recommended, it is going to break a lot of stuff, break a lot of websites. So that is just something to keep in mind. Click over to security, standard protection on that's fine. Something I'll mention on the DNS section. If you do use custom DNS, there's a couple different things here. So you can use with your current service provider. So that will just use whatever the default is through like your ISP or router or whatever. Well, here's the thing. If you have, let's say, if you have your DNS settings set at the operating system level, or you have something like Yoga DNS or Portmaster, something that sets the DNS settings at the operating system level, for example, where it forces all the connections through, let's say, Quad9, and then you want to come in here to, let's say, you want to set this to Next DNS, you're going to have issues with websites loading. A lot of times what'll happen is you'll get a page that you'll go to click into a website and wait for it to load, and it will eventually time out, say the page was unable to load. So if you're going to set DNS settings at the operating system level, you do not want to configure this. If you don't use anything that overrides it at the operating system level, then what you can do is come in here and set up a custom DNS, so you can use one of their options or type in your own. Quad9 is public, it's free, it doesn't require an account. They're privacy respecting. That's been basically my favorite one so far. So that's entirely up to you, whatever you want to choose there. Next thing, sites and shield settings. You can come in here and change this stuff around if you want to. So one thing I'll mention, so sites can use JavaScript. Just know if you do turn this off, that it will break a lot of websites because a lot of sites do use JavaScript. Next thing, so there is an option here to use Tor, and I have tried using Tor in the Brave browser before. It's not the ideal way to do it. If you're going to use Tor, I strongly recommend that you use the Tor browser because there's extra privacy and security settings set in there to help protect you. You do have the option to use it here if you're just going to do some casual browsing. I sure as hell would not recommend you use this if you want to access the dark web. It is an option if you want to, but just know it's not really a safe option. I don't particularly care for using this as opposed to just using Tor itself. Like I said, the option is there. Brave Awards, this is the annoying, I don't like this, I think it's bloat, but again, they have to make money somehow, so whatever, it's fine. Because it's easy to turn off. Here's the thing, I've used this browser as a daily driver still. And what I do is I just come in here and I turn this garbage off. I don't want to see this stuff. And it works just fine just turning this stuff off. You're not forced to use it. And then Web3, so this has the option to load up. By the way, you can just ignore this cryptocurrency garbage in here. Anyone out there that's using crypto, I mean, you wouldn't want to use this anyway. You want to use a proper, I would recommend a hardware wallet, but to each their own. Now, it does have the option to use something called unstoppable domains. This is one of those, it's a Web3 blockchain domain, and I think these are going to probably become pretty popular at some point, but I think we're probably still like another 5 or 10 years out before this really becomes a big thing. So, I mean, for the most part, you don't really need to worry about this stuff. It's built in. I think they're just planning ahead. But there's really no use for being able to load up unstoppable domains right now because people just aren't using it. Next thing is the Leo icon. This is their little built-in AI thing. You can just turn this off if you want to. It's built on the Llama 2, which I haven't covered Llama. I haven't really covered LLMs all that much on my channel. I'm going to cover the Llama model at some point. But I don't think this is something that most people really have any interest in, so you can just go ahead and turn that off, and if you don't use it, then, I mean, it's not an issue. Next thing is search, so you can come in here and change this around. So DuckDuckGo, I mean, I think DuckDuckGo is pretty good. They've improved a lot since they came around on the scene years back. Another good one is StartPage. I've heard Quant, I think, is a good one. It's entirely up to you. This stuff works just fine. Haven't had any issues with it. The one, so extensions, I will just mention extensions real quick if you're going to use these. If you're concerned about privacy, Brave is really good at at protecting against fingerprinting. The thing is, once you start adding extensions, it makes our fingerprint unique. And I don't know how many people have seen the video where I made not too long ago talking about why you should use a VPN. This covers the marketing side of things quite a bit. And the more unique your fingerprint is, the more that they are going to be able to track you around the web and figure out what sites you're visiting, what it is you're searching for, show you ads, all that kind of stuff. So I think Brave's a really good browser, and when it comes to fingerprinting, I just prefer to have the extension, not be adding extensions, because it makes the fingerprint much more unique. So typically what I do, and also, so along the lines of the extensions there and all that stuff, so it's to use Hangouts component to enable screen sharing. You can turn that garbage off. I don't know how many people would want to use this. So you can turn that off as well if you want to. The next thing, so there is an option for password manager. Now, if you do want to use, I'm not saying you shouldn't use extensions, because one of the things that I would recommend people do is use like a password manager, a actual like legit password manager, not something managed by your browser, because there's some security issues with that. So what I would recommend in this case is don't use anything in the browser, turn this stuff off. That way you're not having to click and cancel on this stuff. And if you click over on the password thing, you can turn all of this garbage off. That way you don't have to deal with clicking on the pop-ups. If you want to use this as a daily driver browser, I think it's fine to add a password managing extension. It's not going to be that big of a deal, especially if it's one of the really popular ones. I think 1Password is considered like one of the really popular ones. This one here, so languages, check for spelling errors when you type text on web pages. This is just a built-in spell check. I don't think it's really a privacy issue to have it, but some people might feel differently about that. One thing I would recommend is just keep this on. That way files aren't being downloaded without you being aware of it. And if you're going to use the built-in VPN service, which I'm not sure why people would, it's an option if they want it, you could come in here. I like the WireGuard protocol because WireGuard is really fast. It's a new protocol. It's super lightweight. If you take a look at the code base between WireGuard and OpenVPN, I think OpenVPN has something like 200,000 lines of code, and I think WireGuard has about 8,000 lines of code. It's really fast. It works really well. If it's implemented properly, it's very secure and private. If it's not implemented properly, it can be a privacy issue. I don't know how well Brave has implemented WireGuard because I don't use Brave VPN. It's an option there if people want it. So this may be something, if you do want to use this and you are concerned about your privacy, I would just look at how they have WireGuard implemented, because the way WireGuard was set up, and it's just a limitation of how it is, and maybe they'll change it in the future. I don't know whether or not they will. There's a bunch of articles out there about it. I can't remember all the details off the top of my head, but it's something about how it keeps kind of like this identity of sorts of the person using a VPN. So like I said, as long as it's been implemented properly, then it should refresh those unique keys every however often, every day or so. That way you don't have like all these long stored unique identifiers about who you are. And with all that being said, that wraps the video up. That is how you can tweak Brave to get the best privacy and best settings. And like I said, I'm using it as daily driver like 70% of the time. It works great, and I've got other browsers to use when I need to use them for whatever specific purpose. But this has been great as a daily driver. I know some people got really upset about my browser tier list video. I use like 6 or 7 browsers off of that list, even the ones that aren't in S tier. I still think they're good browsers, and I think Brave is an excellent browser still. I don't like the bloat that's in there, but whatever. It's just something you can work around. I haven't had any issues with it. So anyway, it's going to wrap the video up. I hope you have a good day. Merry Christmas to everyone. I know this video is coming out a little late. I probably should have done that, the Merry Christmas thing, a little sooner, because I'm sure by this time people are kind of wrapping all of that up. But anyway, hope you have a good one, and I will catch you on the next video.